Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I am Professor Ikramur Rahim. Today we are discussing a new chapter, hematology. Previously we have covered all the other chapters of the medicine. Now this is the last topic to discuss with you in the lecture form. I think you have read all these things from your books. Now hematology is a little bit tricky medicine, part of the medicine, and you must be careful, listen these things and read carefully from your books. Now first of all we discuss with the in the blood examination, when you ordered the your paramedics or your patients go for the blood examination, you order you write just complete blood count examination, which is abbreviated as CBC, complete blood count examination, or CP, you frequently write this. And the blood count examination basically covered where you find the hemoglobin levels, you will find the reticulocyte count, hematocrit levels, MCV, and the platelets count, white blood cells count, total white blood cells count, and differential DLC, differential leukocytes count, where you see the neutrophil, lymphocytes, monocyte, eosinophil, and basophils. So your whole blood CBC examination covered all these aspects. Hemoglobin, you must know that the in the male normal hemoglobin is 15.5 grams per deciliter, while its range is 12 to 16 grams per deciliter, while in the females it is 13.5 to 17.5 grams per deciliter. And while the hematocrit values, men 47%, women 41% is the normal. Reticulocyte count usually less than 1%, and other aspects, platelets are 2 lakhs and 50,000 are almost normal, but the range is 1,50,000 to 4 lakhs per microliter. Total white blood cells counts range is the 4,500 to 11,000. This is the normal range, while mostly this covered with the neutrophils, and the almost 59 or 60% to 75%, and the lymphocytes cover almost 34%, while other fractions of the cells like monocyte, eosinophil, and basophils are less in amount. Okay, now we see the microscopic picture of the blood. This is also covered in the CBC test, microscopic picture. Means this is usually previously this test is also done on the machines, automatic machines, but with the microscopic examination we get the minor details, like the patients may have the you will see that it is written in microcytosis or microcytic. Microcytic means micro as the meaning small in size, means red blood cells are small in size. This is usually seen in the iron deficiency anemia, sideroblastic anemia, and thalassemia, means the cell size is small. Micro means small in size in cells. Other sometimes it is written in the blood picture macrocytosis. It's the reverse of the micro. Macro means large in size. Basically the RBCs are larger than the normal size. The cause is the megaloblastic anemia, means B12 deficiency, liver diseases, and also the alcoholism. These are the main causes of the macrocytosis. Moreover, sometimes you see the hypochromic picture. Hypochromic means RBCs contains less amount of hemoglobin. Okay, the microcytic hypochromic typically seen in iron deficiency anemia. Sometimes it is written that in your blood picture anisocytosis. This means RBCs are of different size. This is usually seen in megaloblastic anemia. sometimes it is written poikilocytosis. RBCs are of different shapes. This usually is seen in the dyserythropoiesis. Sometimes it is written target cells. Okay, target cells are basically seen in the usually the liver disease or hypospleenism and thalassemia. These are the shape, size and pictures, how they look like under the microscope. Sometimes it is written punctate basophilia or basophilic stipplings. Abnormally basically damaged red, these are the abnormally damaged red blood cells, and this is usually seen mostly in the chronic lead poisoning and beta thalassemia. Other picture sometimes written Howell jelly bodies. Howell jelly bodies basically indicates hyposplenism or asplenism, means spleen is not working, and also seen in the megaloblastic anemia. These are the condition where you see Howell jelly bodies. If the blood picture shows Howell jelly bodies, one diagnosis comes into your mind is that spleen is not functioning properly. Other is the nucleated red blood cells. Basically, usually in our blood picture, the nucleated red blood cells are not present. If they are present, they are abnormal. These are the immature cells, and they show that the red blood cells production in the bone marrow is increased, especially in the leukemias and hemolysis, myelofibrosis. Other is the hypersegmented polymorphism, means 5 or more lobes are seen, and this is usually seen in the megaloblastic anemia. Other picture is the leukoerythroblastic picture. Here you see leuko means white blood cells, erythro means red blood cells, blast means immature cells. So we find the immature RBCs and WBCs seen in the blood, and this is usually seen in the condition like the excessive hemolysis or bleeding disorders, and other condition is the myelofibrosis, means immature cells are produced from the red blood cells and they goes directly to the blood. Normally these cells are not present on the blood picture. Now we come to the causes of the white blood cells. White blood cells are very important. They form our body defense system, and there are the few causes which causes the increased in the count of the white blood cells, particularly the neutrophil. We call it as neutrophilia. Many causes means one important cause is the infection, which we commonly meet in our practice. If the patient has a pneumonia or abscess formation, his neutrophil count is increased. Other important cause is one is bacterial infection, other is the fungal infection. Other cause is the sometime drug induced. Many drugs like epinephrine, corticosteroids, which are usually we give in the asthma or the in the joint disorders, and lithium, which is antipsychotic drugs, venom, poisons or toxin, they are all cause the increase in neutrophil count, which is known as neutrophilia. Tissue necrosis means tissue inflammation like gout, burns, trauma, infarction, they are also called neutrophilia. Other causes are autoimmune diseases, stress, increased physical activity, pregnancy. Especially in pregnancy, the white blood cells count are increased, and we call this as normal phenomenon, normal physiological phenomenon. Other cause is the smoking, acute hemorrhage, post-splenectomy, myeloproliferative disorders. Other causes are the metabolic causes like the diabetic ketoacidosis, uremia, eclampsia, thyrotoxicosis. They all causes lead to the increase in the neutrophil count. As a result, we see the increased WBC count. Now the reverse of the neutrophilia is the neutropenia or leukopenia, where you see the decreased in number of the white blood cells. reduction is caused is divided into main two part: reduction in granulocytes, decreased production from the bone marrow like the marrow aplasia. It may be some drug induced. Other cause is the drugs and immune mechanism, which leads to the destruction of the neutrophil calcium. And the other is congenital, like idiopathic, and we see the benign ethnic, which are very common. When the severe granulocytosis, we see the drugs, and usually cause is the drugs, especially I tell you the which cause the neutropenia are the NSAIDs, anti-thyroid drugs, captopril, which is used in the blood pressure control. Okay, NSAIDs, anti-thyroid drugs like the numerazole, captopril, anti-convulsant drug used in epilepsy, anti-malarial drugs, and sulfonamides. The infections which usually caused are the viral salmonella infection, especially salmonella typhi, you see the white blood cells count are decreased in number. Other is the malaria. Other cause of the neutropenia is may be due to related with autoimmune diseases and alcoholism. If we see these patients, we usually met with infections. Patients have the usually oral ulcer like white thick pus, which is known as the pseudomembrane. Here you see the pseudomembrane, here you are seeing the pseudomembrane, and usually it is covered with a fungus, we call it as oral candidiasis. Patient have the white coated tongue. In the neutropenia you see the white coated tongue. Patients have the decreased immunity. Eosinophilia is another important cause, which you usually see in the allergic reactions like asthma, hay fever, urticaria rashes, angioneuritic, and the edema. And other causes of the eosinophilia is the parasitic infections like the trichomoniasis, filariasis, and the other bacterial infection, and the intestinal parasite like ascariasis, tinea infections. These are all infections which cause to the eosinophilia. Skin disorder like pemphigus, pemphigoid, eczema, psoriasis, they all lead to eosinophilia. Drug hypersensitivity reactions, especially iodides, penicillamine, allopurinol, this is the detailed, they all lead to the eosinophilia, where you see the increased number of the eosinophil count. Now we come with the clotting system or coagulation system. Nature has made the our coagulation system in a way that it balanced everything. There are the certain factors which cause the clotting in the blood. When this is needed, when there is bleeding, there are the other systems which prevent the clotting, to decrease excessive clotting occur and nerving of the blood system. So nature has produced a balance in coagulation and anticoagulation system. The anticoagulation system keep the our blood in a fluid state, otherwise blood will clot in the small blood vessels. So vascular endothelial surface play in this case a very crucial role to keep the blood in fluidity. How they keep? They prevent the platelet from activation. They prevent the fibrin accumulation on the on the endothelial surface of the blood blood vessels. So by this way they keep the fluidity in the blood, otherwise blood will clot. The basically the coagulation system has the two components. They work simultaneously but independently. One is the activation of the blood. For the clotting, it is essential that there should be activation of the platelets, there should be activation of the fibrin. Without this, clotting does not occur. So there are two mechanisms which lead to activation of platelets, and different mechanism which leads to activation of fibrin, which is the tissue effector, which is extrinsic pathway of the clotting, and there is other pathway which is known as the intrinsic pathway of clotting. I am just giving you just the names of these things. Detailed of this you have read in the your physiology chapters. There is a lot of detail is written in this. But in medicine we just know the names of these things. Here is a picture, but you must know that there is a pathway, extrinsic pathway, and this leads to the tissue factor, factor number 7, and prothrombin time is disturbed in this case if the tissue, this factor number 7 is deranged. Other is the factor intrinsic pathway, which operate in a way that factor number 12, 11, 9 and 8, they activate, and this lead both leads to activation of factor 10. Here they meet together and this leads to the thrombin formation, and thrombin formation leads to fibrinogen activation and fibrin clot pathway. Here the activated partial thromboplastin time is disturbed. If this factor is low, PT is prolonged. If this one is disturbed, APTT is prolonged. Other system which operate for anticoagulation system is the antithrombin 3. Antithrombin 3 is basically most important, and they inactivate the thrombin and other activated coagulation factors. Other is protein C and S, where they basically destroy the factor number 5 and 8. And other is the tissue factor pathway inhibitor, TFPI, and they inhibit the tissue factor or extrinsic pathway of coagulation. Other is the fibrinolytic system, which operate by the way of plasmin, and they destroy the plasmin. So this is a balanced system in our body, that one system operate, they lead to the clotting or coagulation. There is other pathway which check on this clotting mechanism, and they stop excessive clotting, and this is known as the anticoagulation system. Both operate in our body in a way that they maintain a fluidity in the blood, and whenever there is requirement of the clotting, this lead to the cause the clotting and stoppage of the blood. If this pathway is disturbed, especially if the patient have the congenital deficiency of antithrombin 3 or protein CS, this leads to the excessive clotting. We see the in medicine patients have the developed the DVT, means deep vein thrombosis. So this is the very important thing that you must know, that there is a system which leads to clotting, and there is another check on this clotting system which is known as the anticoagulation system. Now we see the what is the role of the vascular endothelial in this clotting mechanism. Basically they produce the platelets inhibitor, which is known as the prostaglandin I2. Other is the production of thrombin inhibitors. These are the heparin and other proteoglocans. They lead to the activation of antithrombin. So our vascular endothelium has a role in the coagulation pathway in a way that it inhibits the clotting or coagulation on its surface. Otherwise, on the surface, whenever the surface of the endothelium is eroded or damaged, this leads to excessive clotting, and they lead to the stoppage of blood flow. But the nature has made a check on the vascular endothelium system in the form of platelet inhibitors and antithrombin. This leads this stop excessive clotting on its surface. Okay, now when the patient presents to us with a bleeding disorder, how we evaluate, how we take the history, and what questions we usually ask from the patients. Questions which usually ask from the patient is that, is this a spontaneous bleeding? I will tell you in detail in the further slides. Spontaneous or with the trauma? Is the bleeding occur after trauma or surgery? Normal hemostasis after trauma occurred or not? Is there a family history of unusual bleeding? These are very important questions which we ask from the patients, because they have the relationship. I will tell you in the detail. Coexisting medical conditions, like if the patient has the liver disease or renal failure, because these mechanisms operate in coagulation way. Hematological disorders are usually anticoagulants like the heparin or the warfarin or NSAIDs. Pattern of the bleeding, whether the bleeding occur on the superficial surface or mucocutaneous surface, or in the bleeding occur in the joints and the deep tendons, like the in the defect in coagulation pathway, like in the hemophilia like diseases. So these are important questions which we usually ask. Now we ask the patients, what is the site of the bleeding? Site of the bleeding is very important in a way that muscles and joint bleeding usually, as I have told you, indicates the coagulation defects. While purpura or superficial bleeding, this occurs due to the prolonged bleeding from the superficial cuts or epistaxis or GI hemorrhage. This is due to the failure of the platelets or the possibility of von Willebrand disease. So this is an important thing, is that we ask from the site of the bleeding, whether the bleeding occur in the joints or on the skin or superficial area. Other is the for how long is this history. It may be possible to assess whether the patient has a congenital or acquired diseases. If the patient has a congenital diseases, he give you the history that he has the recurrent such episodes. If it is acquired, it has a short history. He may be using some drugs like NSAIDs or warfarin, and he will give you the history that since the use of this drug, I have frequently sees these purpuric rashes or skin bleeding. Okay, this is the very important for how long this bleeding is occurring. Other is the muscle and joints, I have already told you, and for the purpura, I have already covered. Now for the people who have met with the surgery, like the dental extraction or some tonsillectomy or circumcision, which is very important, you must ask that how was the bleeding during these processes, because if the hemostatic system operate in a normal way, this is excessive bleeding does not occur. Moreover, bleeding in these cases starts immediately after the surgery. This indicates that there is defect in the platelets plug formation. While if the bleeding occurs after several hours, this means now the on the platelets plug there should be fibrin clot, and there is defect in fibrin clot, that's why the bleeding occur after several hours after the surgery. Okay, this is very important thing you ask from the questions. Family history, like if they have the family history, usually see in the diseases like hemophilia, other family, there may be history. I am saying there may be, not 100%. The patient has the history that his other family members have the such disease, that bleeding tendencies there, and the bleeding frequently occur. Other question is the systemic disease, whether you have the some liver disease, kidney disease or paraproteinemia, where the bleeding occur excessively because the coagulation system is disturbed in this disease. Other question you ask is the drug use, especially the drugs like the aspirin or warfarin or other drugs, they usually cause the bone marrow suppression or decrease in the platelets count or thrombocytopenia. So these are very important questions which usually ask from in the history. Now the findings which are suggestive of a bleeding disorder means, if the patient gives you the history that he has the unprovoked, other means without any reason, if they have the bleeding which is more than 5 cm in diameter, or there is frequently unprovoked epistaxis or gums bleeding, or patients have the menorrhagia or unknown cause of the iron deficiency or iron deficiency anemia, heme arthrosis, or excessive surgical bleeding, or family history, or some kidney diseases, or usually bleeding due to some medication use, all these shows that the patient has some bleeding disorder. and these are the important clues which usually patient gives to you or you usually ask from the patient. Please mind it, you must in the dentistry, very important thing is you ask these things, whether bleeding occurs spontaneously or whether there is previous history or family history or there is anemia or the some drug use or some liver kidney diseases. You must ask these questions from the patient where you see the excessive bleeding or unusual bleeding from a minor procedure. Now is the important investigation we usually do in the excessive bleeding is the platelet count, with whether the patient has a normal platelet count or decreased. Decreased platelet count is known as the thrombocytopenia. Other is the bleeding time, means bleeding time is prolonged, especially in the platelet dysfunction, thrombocytopenia, wall Willebrand disease. Other investigation which usually ask is the PT, mean partial thromboplastin time. This is usually prolonged in the warfarin use, liver disease or DIC. We ask the APTT. APTT is prolonged in the heparin, hemophilia A or B and DIC. Other is the investigation which usually order is the D-dimer. This is usually increased in the fibrinolysis or DIC. These are the investigations you must know that whenever you meet excessive bleeding, you write down in his paper that go for these investigations. Platelets count, bleeding time, PT, APTT and D-dimer. These sets of investigations are very important, especially when you see that there's increased bleeding is going on and you have done a minor procedure. Now we come with the bleeding disorder, which is known as the thrombocytopenia. This is basically a basic structure which you have seen in the your physiologic books. Now what are the causes of the thrombocytopenia, mean decreased in the platelets count? This occurs usually in the marrow aplasia. Marrow aplasia may be primary or drug induced. The cause may be the marrow aplasia or marrow infiltration or nutritional deficiency, especially B12 and folic acid deficiency. Marrow failure usually occurred in the megaloblastic anemia, infiltration by the malignant cells, leukemia, multiple myeloma, solid tumor infiltration in the bone marrows, myelofibrosis. These are the conditions where you see the marrow infiltration or marrow failure. Basically the bone marrow is the factory where the platelets are produced. Here are the conditions which usually affects the bone marrow. Now is the condition which leads to the destruction of the platelets, like the ITP, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. Other is the DIC, disseminated intravascular coagulation, post blood transfusion purpura. These are the condition where the platelets destruction occur. Other causes are the increased sequestration of the platelets in the spleen. Basically spleen is the area where the partially destroyed cells are captured. If the spleen leads to the excessive functions, it usually acquired more and more platelets. This leads to decreased in platelets count. We see usually in that in the patient with the cirrhosis or CLD, their platelets counts are decreased. Condition we call it as hypersplenism, usually occurred in the cirrhosis and myeloproliferative disorders. Now the qualitative platelet disorder, these may be inherited like the Bernard-Solar syndromes. They may be acquired like the drugs are the NSAIDs, which I have already told you, and the other drugs which leads to the platelets destructions. Renal failure and von Willebrand disease, other is the pseudo thrombocytopenia, which is usually very common. Now the clinical features with patients with the decreased platelets count is the superficial or recurrent bleeding, sometimes the mucocutaneous bleeding like the petechial hemorrhages, ecchymosis, epistaxis and gums bleeding, bleeding from the cannula side where you place the prenula. Other causes are the prolonged bleeding from the minor cuts or minor injuries, and when you see the investigation you meet that the patient has the prolonged bleeding time, and due to the recurrent bleeding patient develop the anemia, means patient have the decreased white blood cells count. So these are the clinical features and investigation which usually perform. Now this is the picture where you see the petechiae are basically pinpoint small rashes, red rashes, pinpoint rashes, and they occur usually in the crops or groups. Here you see there is the petechial rashes. Here you see the foot you are seeing. Here is the back of the patient where you are seeing many petechial rashes, small rashes on the back of the patient. Other definition which usually used in the medicine is the ecchymosis or bruises. Bruises basically are more than 2 millimeter in size. Here you are seeing the small rashes and this is the large or ecchymosis. This is the ecchymosis. Here you see the small rashes and this is the excessive large rash which is known as the ecchymosis or bruises. So there is a minor difference between petechiae and ecchymosis because the cause is same. Cause is same means patient has a platelet dysfunction. If you see the small rashes on the skin, one diagnosis comes into your mind is that patient has a defect in the platelets, whether its count is decreased or platelet function is decreased. But cause is same, that the patient has the platelets dysfunction. Whenever you see the petechial rashes, okay, then you go for the cause of this platelets dysfunction. You do the investigations. Here is the rash which contains the small petechial rashes and mixed ecchymosis and bruises rashes. This is the mixed picture where you see the rashes on the legs. So cause I have told you is the same, means this cause is the platelets dysfunction or the platelets count is decreased. And when we go for the treatment is that we have seen that dysfunction may be due to the number of the decreased number of the platelets or dysfunction of the platelets. So number may be decreased due to some drugs like the aspirin and NSAIDs. These are frequently used by the patients. It may be prescribed by some doctor. Our patient is usually in our clinical practice taking its own, that I have the pain in my joints, that's why previously doctor started this drug, now I have spontaneously started the Brufen and I am taking Brufen for the last 3 months. Well, okay, you ask who prescribed you, he will give you the reply that I have spontaneously started because doctors also use these medicines. Okay, so this is usually come, you should ask the whenever you meet this excessive bleeding and you find the petechial rashes on the skin, ask that whether you are using some drugs or not. Now is the treatment of the underlying cause. This means if the patient has some liver disease or kidney disease, treat that cause, the platelets function will improve. If the patient has a hypersplenism, remove the spleen by splenectomy, the platelets function will improve its own way. Other is the treatment part is the replacement, means now you are meeting a patient which has excessive bleeding is going on, you should not wait for the results of above two treatment. You immediately go for the platelets transfusion. There are the mega units available in the hospitals. You give the platelets mega units. Example of this is that in the dengue fever, where the patients have the decreased number of the platelets count, we transfuse the platelets mega units. In other condition like ITP, you want some surgery, you infuse the patient platelets mega units. You are treating the underlying cause, but at the first place is that to save the life of the patient. So you immediately order that go for the platelets transfusion. At that time it is a life saving procedure. Same applied in your dentistry, that the, if the patient has excessive bleeding, start from the minor procedure of the tooth extraction, and now you are seeing that it is a life threatening, that if the patient has the excessive bleeding from the same side, his life may be endangered and he may go into the hypovolemic shock. So you ask immediately to go for the platelets transfusion. Go to the hospital and the hospital will give you the mega units of the platelets. So this is very important, that you must know the treatment options available in the market. So this is today's lecture, which basically covered the basics of the clotting pathway and basics of the hematology. In the next next my lectures, I will cover the further diseases and cover the whole of one by one, cover whole of the platelet disorder, white blood cell disorders and the red blood cells disorder. Thank you very much. If you have any query or some question, you can send to me on my WhatsApp group. I will definitely reply to you. Thank you very much.